parka, a capital journey product. And journey I did, from the jungles of Cambodia, to motorbiking from end to end of Vietnam, to traversing the mountainous regions of the Philippines, and back to the peace's ocean country, Japan, just in time for Hanami season. And having owned the jacket for 2 years, I wore it even before this journey, through classes, hikes, and city exploration. And believe it or not, I've only hand washed it and hang dried it a couple of times. Thankfully, the material is resilient to water, dirt, and odors. It has almost become an extension of myself, and I feel the need to give it a proper overview for those unfamiliar with Capital. I've grown quite fond of the brand. Its unique designs and colors are inspired by both traditional Japanese attire and vintage Americana. And this jacket, raincoat, pillow combination is a perfect example of a signature piece from Capital. For there are several different ways to wear it, and I will share each of these methods and a few more, for I was actually unaware of all of them until I came across this poster at the Capital store in Kyoto. For starters, the jacket has a bag sewn to the back of it, which you can fold into for storage, or as I have used it on multiple night buses, as a pillow. The bag can also be rolled up and used as a neck pillow or for more inventive looks, as you'll soon see. Other utilities include one zip pocket on the inner left breast for secure carry, drawstrings on the inner waist, back of the hood, and on either end of the bottom for fit adjustments, and a large hidden zip pocket on the left bib. I say hidden because this portion of the jacket can be rolled up for various looks, concealing that pocket. Moreover, there are two Velcro fastened pockets on the front of the jacket. And now, onto the fits. The first look I'm showing is the mountain way, and is characterized by fastening both sides of the bibs to their respective snap buttons, keeping the bag down, which can also be held down by snap buttons, and making use of the hood. Second is the kimono way, and to achieve this look, both bibs must be rolled up with the Velcro fastenings. The kimono straps can also be tied in the front for a more secure fit. For the next fit, the bag must be rolled up. The ends of it must be placed through the holes in the hood. Now some may be questioning the holes in the hood, and yes, I must say I can feel both wind and rain when the weather isn't too chipper. Otherwise, I don't pay them much mind, but I do appreciate the added looks that they afford. Perhaps what could have been a better design is some form of snap closure for the holes. But nevertheless, from here the bag can be rolled out slightly on both ends to achieve a more voluminous, horn-shaped look. From here, a carabiner can be used to link the holes on the ends of the bag to achieve the look of the poncho way, which is characterized by this neck fastening. The carabiner I'm using is also from Capital. I purchased it from the store in Kyoto. Next is the sleeping way, which gets rid of the carabiner and sees to it that the front sides are unfastened and then secured to the snap buttons on each side. Essentially, this is the method that keeps you both secure and in comfort, making use of the neck pillow feature. Moving on, the kabuki way is similar to the previous one, except the front parts of the jacket are secured to their respective Velcro positions. It is one of my favorite ways to wear the jacket, with the horn-shaped bag sticking out of the holes in the hood. And these aren't the only ways to wear this jacket. The Creative Liberty one is afforded by it is immense. Some of the styles to consider are this one, which I call half-baked, and this one, which I call open potato. One can even try it inside out for an even more covert look. There you have it, the Capital Military Anorak Blouson. Let me know if you'd like to see more Capital reviews, or more fittings, or in-depth reviews of other pieces. Thank you for watching.